If you want to know how to partition an SSD in Windows 11, then you are at the right place, as here is how to do so. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. If you are wondering how to partition an SSD in Windows 11 or 10, you are at the right place. This expert guide will focus on creating the partition in two different ways. We often use an SSD solid-state drive to boost the computer's performance. It's known to speed up the apps and boot time, thus improving the speed of your device significantly. To know about the easy ways to protect your SSD, you can follow this guide. However, if you want to use the SSD in a single partition, follow this video to know how to partition an SSD on your Windows. Let's get started. How to partition an SSD in Windows 11. When you create a partition in SSD, you can allocate the partition based on the data type. You can distribute data to specific partitions. For example, images to one partition, movies in another music, documents, and so on. This helps you recover data easily if the hard drive gets corrupted. Besides, you can move or install your Windows operating system to one partition or make space for a new OS. Now let's see how to partition an SSD in Windows 11. How to partition an SSD via Windows settings. In this method, we need to access the storage management settings that help you to create, shrink, or delete partitions in SSD. Since the system partition, which is actually the C drive, covers the entire SSD, you must first free up some space before you create the portion in SSD. For this, you must begin with the shrinking process as shown. 1. Shrink the system partition in Windows settings. Open Windows settings by pressing Win plus I hotkeys on the keyboard. Click on System and then Storage. From the right pane, navigate to Advanced Storage Settings and expand the section. Select Disks and Volumes. On the next screen, select Partition and click on Properties. Next, under Size, click on the Change Size button. In the Change Size window, input the desired size for the partition and press OK to save the changes. Now, wait till Windows finishes resizing the partition. 2. Create a partition for the unallocated space. Once the partition process is complete, go back to the Disk Volume Settings page. Here, select Unallocated to expand the section and click on the drop-down menu for Create Volume. Select Create Simple Volume. In the New Volume window, mention the label, drive letter, file system, and size in MB. Press Format. Once done, you should see the new partition in the Disk and Volumes list. To modify the label and the drive letter, select the new partition and click on Properties. In the next window, you can either select Change Label or Change Drive Letter to make the changes. 3. Delete and merge the partition. Alternatively, you can also remove the partition and merge it back again to the earlier volume. But before that, make sure you create a backup of your data. Now, select the new partition and click on Properties. On the next screen, scroll down and hit the Delete button. Click on Delete Volume to confirm. Now, as you return to the Disks and Volume screen, select the previous partition and click on Properties. On the next screen, go to Size and press the Change Size button. Input the max size in MB and press OK to apply the changes. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.